everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Mimi. If you guys are new, if you guys are not new, thank you so much for coming back to my channel and tuning in again. So today's video, I have a what's my bag for you guys, and it's going to be on this bag right here. This is the latest in my collection. It's the Chanel Classic Flap Caviar with gold hardware. So I'm really excited to share this with you today. And I was planning on filming this video already, but because you guys were asking for it on Instagram, I thought I would sit down and film it for you guys today. I hear a lot of you guys on Instagram that you guys want to see more purse-related videos. So although I'm not doing a ton of unboxings or anything, a lot of you still wanted to see like what's my bags, reviews, comparisons and stuff, so I'm definitely more than happy to film those for you guys. So here is a what's my bag today. A lot of you were requesting this bag and the Alma BB, so I thought I would do this one first and the Alma BB later. So make sure you guys stay tuned for that if you guys want to see a what's my bag for the Alma BB. But right now I am currently using this bag because of course whenever you get a new bag you're using it a lot more than normal than the other bags. So I'm definitely enjoying this beauty right here. I do have a unboxing on my channel already. If you guys haven't checked it out, I'll link it down below for you guys. And that video also has mod shots in it. So definitely check that video out if you guys are looking for those kind of details and stuff. But this one's strictly going to be a what's my bag and what can fit. So let's go ahead and get into this video. I will talk about the features more in this video. In my unboxing, I didn't go too in depth of the features on this bag. And yeah, so we'll go ahead and do that today. So this bag is a double flap and it also has a back pocket there. When you open it up, you have a little zipper here and you can unzip it, but you can't put anything in it. There's no way you can put anything. I don't know what you can put in here, like not even a little piece of paper or Trident gum can fit. But you can use this back pocket here. I just have like a Petco receipt in there just in case I need to return anything my cats don't like. So that is interesting. Here's the inside of the second flap. It has a big compartment with two smaller compartments, and the middle part is supposed to be for a lipstick. And in the front, you just have a really thin pocket there. So even though this has a lot of pockets, I feel like it doesn't hold that much, to be honest with you. I think this bag is great for every day for somebody who isn't like a vlogger or need like a ton of things, because as you guys can see, it's pretty filled in there and I try not to stuff it too much because I know it's going to wear the bag down even more. So let's go ahead and get on with the contents in this bag and what I have. So I do have a receipt back here like you guys saw. It's a Petco receipt. In the bigger compartment, I will have some Advil. I put my Advil in a small Ziploc bag because this is just easy to carry around and switch into different bags, and it's small. When it's in the actual container like I used to carry around, I realized it was too big for bags like this, and it's just easier to carry around a little bit of it. So if you get like a big size Advil, you can definitely like separate them in little Ziploc bags and just put them out throughout all your bags. The next thing I have in here is my card holder. I just carry a thin one whenever I'm using this bag. I try to use something like this because I think the YSL one's just a little bit too long. So when it's like stacked in there with my keys, it's a little bit too bulky. Like not in the sense of bulky, but it's like too long, so it takes up too much space and they overlap each other. So with this, it doesn't overlap with my keys, so I'd rather would carry one of these. So right now it's this one. Sometimes I'll use my black one, but yeah, so far it's this one. And speaking of keys, here are my keys. So as you can see, it's a little bit bulky because I have so many keys and a AirTag in here. I didn't have an AirTag in my bag for a long time, but now that I do, it takes up a lot of space because it makes my keys super bulky, as you can see. And then next I have my AirPods. I always have to have these on with me. And I have a tampon. I can't carry too many, you know, tampons and panty liners with me in this bag, so I just have to carry one of each. So I have that, and I carry a panty liner just in case as well. And then I have two lipsticks in here. Right now I'm wearing the Morphe Backseat Love, and then I also have this one. It's the Timeless Beige. This is like the La Rouge Duo. It's a gloss and matte lipstick and it's supposed to be long wearing all day. If you want something that's more like a glossy look, I definitely would say get this. If you like the more matte look, Morphe's matte lipsticks are the best. This one, Backseat Love, and Virgin are my favorites. I have a receipt from lunch when I took my sister-in-law out for her birthday. And then I have a eyelash wand in here. I keep this with me because I do have eyelash extensions, so I like to keep one in my bag so that way I can, you know, brush my eyelashes out if I need to, especially when they start to kind of start balding a little bit. They need to be brushed out sometimes to make it look more fluffy. You definitely don't want to use one that's floating around in your bag and then putting it to your eye. Like, that's not sanitary at all, so I highly recommend getting one of those. The last thing in that big compartment is this lotion. I have the Snowflakes and Cashmere lotion from Bath & Body Works. If you guys have been watching me for a while, there's something about me you guys will realize. I love lotions and hand cream. So this is my favorite hand cream from Bath & Body Works. I think it's only available during the holidays, and I literally grabbed a handful out of the container because I was like, dude, if I'm not gonna have this for the rest of the year, I might as well get a bunch. But now I have so much hand creams I need to go through because I got some from all different kind of brands and stuff. The next part is this front flap here. There's not too much in it because it is pretty skinny. So in here I do carry some wet ones, and this was actually recommended by another subscriber. She told me to grab some of these to put in my bags because then they don't leak and, you know, ruin your bags. So I'm really grateful for you to give me that tip because I was carrying around like the big packs. I feel like for my bigger bags I will put like the bigger wet ones in, but for this bag, since it's so small, I think these are perfect for it. So if you do have smaller mini bags, these are great to carry. If you can carry the whole pack and the inside isn't leather, or you're not like worried about it, or you have like a bag liner or a organizer, that can help if, you know, if you do get leakage. And that's why I don't have hand sanitizers in my bags, just because I'm scared I'm going to spill it or something's going to happen and dry out the leather or the canvas or anything like that. And then I have another receipt here. Oh, it's for sushi. And then in here I also have a face mask. This is a clean one. I just like to keep this in here because sometimes I might forget one, or if my face mask rips or something, something happens, you know, or somebody else even, like, you have an extra mask that they can use or you can use. And then I also have a parking pass from when I went to go eat at Sun and Garden, because you have to pay for parking there if you can't find any street parking, and that's what happened to us. We couldn't find any street parking. And in the back pocket here, I do have $20. I just put that in there because I'm getting a car wash tomorrow and I wanted to make sure I have money for tip in there. So I just put that back here just so I have it handy and ready. And I just want to note that my phone does fit in here. It does actually even fit in this front pocket here. But because of everything that I carry, it doesn't fit my phone. I do carry quite a bit of things, so I do definitely have to downsize if I do want to make room for my phone in this bag. So if my bag is full of all these items, I do have to hold my phone or put it in a pocket because it will not fit. I think it'll just overstuff the bag and stress it out. But I will show you guys right now how I would fill up this bag and show you guys, you know, what I have to compromise with if I do want to carry my phone in this bag. Alright everyone, let's go ahead and repack this bag. It's going to be kind of hard to show you, that's why I have to do it in this angle, because it's hard for me to like hold it out like this to show you guys. I will definitely do my best, but so far I do have my face mask in here. And then we'll do the wet ones in here. Like so. And then I can probably put my pen liner in there as well, just to put that in there. And I can show you guys that my phone can fit in here perfectly. Okay, so let's go ahead and put the card holder in. So, my keys, my big, fat, bulky keys, like this. So I'll show you guys what it looks like inside. Like that. I try to keep my fob on top because it's so bulky. So it looks like that inside so far. AirPods, my lotion. So you guys see the AirPods in there. My lotion, I'll put it in the back behind the card holder. And then the lipsticks will go on top of the lotions, like so. You do have to kind of play Tetris a little bit, I'm not gonna lie. It is a little bit tricky sometimes if everything's a little bit bulky. I'll put my battery in one of the pockets here so it's easy access. I'm not digging around for it, because when I used to put it inside floating in the bag, I would have a hard time finding it. So that's gonna go there. Then the tampons and eyelash wand will go there. And then the pack of Advils. So as you can see, there is absolutely no room for my phone. I would definitely have to take out quite a bit of stuff if I do want to bring my phone with me. It kind of sucks because sometimes I just want to throw my phone in my bag, but this is already pretty stuffed to me. So I try not to put the phone in there if I don't need to. So I'm going to take all these out, like the wand and stuff, the lipsticks. I can keep my AirPod Pros in there. Or no, I gotta take that out. Take out the AirPod Pros as well. So right now I just have the card holder and the keys. Now my phone can fit perfectly in the back behind the card holder, as you can see. So from here, I could only bring like maybe one lipstick. Let's do the Chanel one because it's skinnier. And then the AirPods can go on top. And then maybe like the Avril because it's small. The lotion, the eyelash wand can go in there, and maybe the tampon. There, so that's with my phone in there. But the downside is that the phone is all the way in the back. And if I grab it, if I grab the phone out, if I want to put it back in, it's going to be a little bit hard there. So I have to be careful with my phone taking it in and out because now everything collapsed in. So I guess the only things I'm compromising is my second lipstick and my lotion, which isn't too big of a deal. I just do like having lotion on me just in case my hands get dry. But things we gotta do, maybe not carry my tampon and put the lotion in there instead on top. So you do have quite a bit of options on what you can bring with you. I mean, like I said, if you are like a vlogger or you do YouTube or something and you do want to carry your camera or you'd like to take pictures and stuff, it's kind of hard to carry everything and be hands-free at the same time. Even though this bag does feature a double strap where you can carry it on one side, I feel like it is a little bit too short to carry it crossbody comfortably for a long period of time. So yeah, that's it to this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys have any other purse-related videos or any videos in general that you guys want to see, please leave a comment down below and I'll try to film it for you guys. But yeah, that's it to this video. Thanks for watching. Bye everyone.